Christmas, of course, a lot of us spend time returning gifts that we just don't want.
Gail Anderson is live in Vernon at a business that wants your department store returns. Explain, Gail.
Yes, this is wild. Again, you return things to the department store. They get overstocked, what have you, and you'll wonder where that stuff goes. Well, it comes here. Let me show you where we are. We're in Via Trading. We're at Via Trading in the city of Vernon, right down from L.A., Alameda. And when you come inside, you see this vast warehouse. Everything you can possibly imagine that has to do with a consumer item is for sale here, either returned or overstocked at a department store. Jacques has been telling us they open at 7 o'clock. As you can see, people are here. And I said to Jacques, does this really work? He says, well, let you talk to Anita Wilson. Anita.
Hi, Gail.
You specialize in kitchenware.
We do.
Does this really work? What's the catch?
It's no catch. You get great quality stuff, name brand products. And it may be that just a scratch and dent or maybe customer return. You know how it is when you get a gift and you don't really want it, but you have to find an excuse because you don't have a ticket.
And then this box behind me is the kind of thing that you handle.
Exactly.
Black and Decker. This is good stuff. Mm-hmm.
Black and Decker, Sensations, Basics, pretty much, you know, all of the...
You make any money just between me and you?
Oh, I make a lot of money.
Okay. All right, let me explain to you where we are. Via Trading. Hopefully you'll hang out with us and next hour we'll talk a little bit more. Because I don't want people to think it's a get rich quick. You got to work a little bit, don't you?
You got to work at it, but it's well worth it.
Okay, all right. We'll pick our brains some more. Anita Wilson, entrepreneur. Can you teach Aunt Gail how to be an entrepreneur? We'll talk a little bit. All right, more next hour, because this is interesting.
It is good stuff. All right, Gailey, thank you.
Okay. Thanks, Gail.
Right. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back. Didn't really get what you wanted for Christmas this year. Gail says it's not too late.
That's right. She is live at a store where you can get a deal on the stuff that you want and return everything else. Hi, Gail.
Yes, this company, Via Trading, they buy department store returns, overstocked items. So one person's trash could be your treasure. For example, this Barbie doll sells for $20, eBay $65. You can get them here for $1.50 for a piece in a case. This is interesting. Profit, profit, profit. Details when we come back.
All right, so we've been talking to Gail all morning about going to this place where you can buy things that people didn't want, the returns from Christmas. But we got a little confused, Gail, because you cannot take something you got for Christmas to them
and trade it. I don't
know
who told you
that. I know,
that,
we got that all confused.
Oh, no, no.
Let's straighten it out.
No. Here's the deal. Good morning.
Yeah, tell us. Live in Vernon. Let's just help you bore you.
It's chilly out here. Okay, that's not what this is. Here, Via Trading, let me show you where they are. We're in Vernon, and this is one of a handful of companies. They get their hands on department store returns. They get them from the big companies or the overstocked items. And here, let me show you some tape of the truck being unloaded. See, that's something you didn't want. Well, it comes here, and then... folks who are somewhat entrepreneurial, they can take those items for resale. I'm standing behind a big television that came from some department store. Somebody didn't want it. And now, and there's a flat screen television as well.
Wow.
And so now there are people here, as you can see, up and down the aisles. They buy either by the case, by the pallet, or by the load. Some people sell on eBay. Some people sell on Craigslist and make a little extra money on the side.
Now, Gail, can I come in and
now,
buy?
Now, everybody can hear you. Let me show you. Jack Stumbly, this is his business, Via Trading.
Hi, Jack.
This is Anita Wilson,
Anita,
who actually runs a business doing this, correct?
Correct.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, two questions. Okay. One, can I come in and buy, let's say, like you had, you know, the toaster ovens or whatever. Do I have to buy a box or pallet of toaster ovens, or
perfect,
can I just come
question
in and buy one?
Okay, who wants to take that?
No, you have to buy the full box.
Okay.
For example, we have one here. This is a pallet of kitchenware,
small appliances.
There are toasters in there, Anita?
There are, some very good ones, dishes.
And you're going to buy that?
Oh, I am.
And some of those are returns. We saw an item that was returned.
Some are returns, some are shelf pulls, some are closeouts. So, I mean, it's probably very little work, if anything, to get them going.
Yeah. Right, and can I make up my own box, like pick one of this, and just buy a box?
That's a good question.
Or is it the way they box it?
That's a good question. Very good.
Unfortunately, no. You have to take what you see is what you get, I'm afraid. But what you see is pretty good, so I wouldn't worry too much about that.
And you have a variety of items. Anita, you specialize in kitchenware. There are shoes here, televisions. Jacques, see the pink shrink wrap items up there? What are those?
That's a whole truck full of appliances, fridges, washing machines, dryers, appliances, dishwashers, a whole truck full of nothing but appliances.
And so if somebody's that's their thing.
If somebody is, if that's their, if that's your thing, then you buy the whole truckload. It'll probably cost you around $250 to $300 a piece.
Okay, and then here's a palette example here. Black & Decker. How much would these sell for?
These would probably sell for around $13 a piece. And just assorted Black & Decker tools.
And you'd have to take the whole pallet, not one.
The whole pallet.
The whole pallet. All right, now, to keep you from being too confused, let me give you some information, because if you're going to, you know, this allows you to make a little extra money on the side. Is that
a lot of extra money? If you work it right, you can make a lot of extra money.
All right, but there's some things you should consider. Here you go. Now, should everyone be purchasing department store returns? If you're not prepared to repair items, do not purchase.
No.
All right, think about that. She says no. Sometimes you have to do that, right?
Yeah, sometimes you do, but, you know, probably one out of every 10 pallet that you get.
All right, hold on, we'll expand that in a moment. If you only want 100% retail-ready items, do not purchase. And let me give you one more item here. If you are not prepared for a percentage of the items to be out of the box, defective, cosmetically blemished, etc., do not purchase. You've experienced some of that?
That's correct.
But that doesn't bother you?
Hasn't stopped me in the least.
All right, and what are you going to purchase today?
Well, you know, I was looking at this one, and like I was telling you earlier about these coffee pots, teapots.
Teapot. You like the teapot?
I love the teapots, and I don't even use them. But these teapots sell for like $40, $50 retail.
Right.
Okay, they're in the box. It may be that they're just out of the box, or like this one's missing a top. You know, and the secret to that, I go to the 99 or funnel a tin can with a silver top, put it on there. You know, and you can get $15-$20 for a $40 teapot. Then you have the Cambridge silversmith. I mean, it's silverware. There's nothing wrong with it. It's missing one piece.
Right.
So what? So somebody doesn't have a salad fork. Big deal. Okay? They're going to eat anyway. Everything else. $20. It's a $35 set of silverware.
Hey, Gail.
Yes?
Where does she resell them then? What does she do?
Oh, she can hear you.
I do eBay. I have a store on eBay. I do Craigslist, which is really good because sometimes it's better than eBay because it's cash now. You don't have to set it up there and wait for days. You can put your price on it and, you know, they call you, they want it, they come pick it up. Or you can do yard sales, garage sales. Word of mouth is really good. And, I mean, you can turn your garage into a retail store and, you know, open and close when you want.
Good for you. Wow.
She made
entrepreneurial spirit in 2008.
All right.
She's giving me ideas.
I'm sure she is. All right, Gail, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Gail's trying to buy that Corvette next year. This could be the way.
This is the way to do it. We'll put more information on our website if you want to find out that place.
Up next, we got some viewer mail.
Be right back.